Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today we gonna discuss about one more interview question that is related to how we can deal with logical combination of words. So before going forward, if you haven't watched part 29 of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video where you can understand how we can get the comma separated values. So let's start with our question. So as we can see, we have input table that contains two columns. First is ID, second is value. And in output, we have two columns. First is ID and second is value. So as we can see in our input, first three rows contains Gagan, Gagan and Gagan. Next three rows contains Deep, Deep, Deep. Then we are having Singh, Singh, Singh. So we want to rotate these values in a single column by Gagandeep Singh, then Gagandeep Singh, and then again Gagandeep Singh. So how we can get the output from this input? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio to write the query for getting this output. So as I am using SQL 2017, you may have another versions of SQL Server, but query would be same for all the versions. So first of all, I would like to execute our first statement, that is for creating the table. So table has been created successfully. Next, I just want to insert record on it. So as we can see, 9 rows affected. So data have been inserted successfully on this table. Now we can execute our select statement to check the data. So we are having the data as we were seen in our slide. Now we can copy this data. And what approach we will follow for that, go to on Excel, and here I wanna paste our input table. And here, as we can see, we are having ID and value. If we will generate a new column with row number and we will do the partition on the value, and we want to generate 1, 2 and 3, then again 1, 2 and 3, and then 1, 2 and 3. As we seen, we are getting the comma separated values in our last to last video. So here we can get 1, then Gagan, then comma, then Deep, then again comma, then Singh. And for 2 and 3, we will get the same data. So this time comma will be replaced by blank. So by using this approach, we will get our output. So go to on SQL Server Management Studio to write the query for getting this output. So here, I want to generate a new column with row number, and then over, as we have discussed, we need to use partition by, on the value, then order by ID. Now I can execute and we are getting the data. Now we need to insert these records in a temporary table. So first of all, I would like to create a temporary table. So create table TMP, and here we want ID, which is our integer value. Then we have value, that is our string value, so varchar 100. And then for our last, this is our row number with integer. And we want to create a primary key on the ID. Then I need to execute this query to create the temporary table. So temporary table has been created successfully. Now I need to insert a record on it. So insert into our temporary table, and we are getting data from this select statement. So as we can see, 9 rows affected. Now we can copy, and I gonna use select asterisk from our temporary table. So here we need to row number, we need to use space separated value. So I gonna use stuff, then select, then we can specify space, and we want to add with value from our temporary table. And then we can put an alias with I, where I dot rw should be equals to o dot rw. And here we can specify for XML path. Here we want to replace extra space which we are getting at the starting of this subquery. So we want to start from 1. Then how many characters we want to replace? We want to replace only one character. From which we want to replace? We want to replace by blank. Now I can close the bracket. Now I can put an alias with S. Now we can execute our select statement. So we are getting duplicate values. So for that we can use distinct, and now we can execute. So we are getting the values as we were expected. So as we can see in our slide, we are getting same output. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.